All right, so here is my cure chamber. And today is the first day of my fermenting stage on my capicola. So that is a like a 3.5 pound pork shoulder section with a lot of marbling that's been cured in wine, some cure salts, juniper berries, a couple other seasonings for a couple days in a bag, and then I have stuffed it into a an ox bung, which is the largest portion of the ox intestine. I've also sprayed the outside of the ox bung with the white bloom bacteria, so it'll get that nice natural bloom, which will keep the bad mold and bacteria out, and also regulate the moisture levels as they leave the capicola. So I'm going to ferment this for probably 8 to 10 weeks, or until it loses 30% of its original weight. I will be hanging my salami from here, which I'm going to tackle this weekend. From here, I have my streaky bacon or American bacon rack there, and I have my back bacon or European bacon rack there. I have these. This is just a whole hog belly section that I'm going to do this dry rub on and cure for 5 days, and then I'll hang it, rinse it off, wipe it down with malt vinegar, and then hang it for another 5 days to cure. And then in here is the European cut bacon that essentially is the pork tenderloin with the fat left on the top and the nice fatty tip left on the side that's normally trimmed off in any butcher shop. I will do, due to the fat, the same size in pounds. They're about right around 5 pounds a piece, but this is a lot thicker, so I will do the dry rub on this for 10 days and then let it hang for 10 days. My salami will take probably 8 to 10 weeks to totally cure, and I'll also use the bacteria on that. And here's the humidifier, which will regulate everything. That runs to three sensors, one's for temperature, one's for humidity, and there's also a temperature sensor for the humidity. I've rewired the fridge, and all of those go up to these two sensors, which can be purchased on eBay. Right now it says it's 15 degrees Celsius. It's set at 12, and you heard it kick on because the door was open. So that will regulate, and this is the humidity sensor, which I need to turn on and set to about 75 degrees or 75% humidity.